Welcome back, Pokemon Platinum. We are in Celestic Town. It's the grandma. We are looking for Cynthia's grandmother, I believe. Saying you'll blow the town up with a bomb. The nerve of it all when we were younger. Sounds like something a task for me. But first, let me grab a Dragon Fang. I think that increases the power of dragon type moves, but I could be wrong. Are you gonna mess with me? Yes, actually. That's unfortunate for you, because I know close combat. Jolteon needs a stronger electric move pretty soon. I mean, Shockwave is good and all, but it does not do the job sometimes. I don't know when it learns a new move, though. That's a problem. It still technically has never learned an electric move. Because I remember I got the TM for Shockwave and I taught it to Jolteon. Elder, that's the one we're looking for. Right. Mysterious designs cover a whole section of the wall. There are three strange things forming a triangle. The middle of them is a shining sphere. What is this all about? Don't know. Could it be the three legendary Pokemon of the lake? You guys just let whoever walk into your town. Well, I definitely did not think we were going to be facing off with Cyrus. That's an unfortunate typing for you. Jolteon. So this means on his team he's going to have a Weavile, Crobat, and then whatever his third Pokemon is. So I imagine this is not the last battle that we have with him for sure. It's poisoned. You know, boss battles always have the percentages on their side. Like, you can't tell me that consistently there's a 10% chance to be poisoned on Poison Fang, yet every single time you go up against a leader on their first hit, Poison Fang, you're poisoned. There's no way. And Murkrow. So we're looking at Weavile, Honchkrow, and Crobat. So far, Jolteon's gonna have to carry that pretty hard. So I don't have a rock type. I don't have a psychic type. Well, psychic for the Crobat, not the Honchkrow. Well, that's not good. Really, it does that much damage. Okay, dude. Really? It does that much? Okay, Fate's Attack is a big 60 power move. There's no way. That was ridiculous. We got Surf. Yes. Oops. Oh, hey, Cynthia. Why didn't you just... What? If you were coming to Celestic Town, why didn't you just drop off the old charm yourself? I mean, I got Surf out of it, but... Oh, I have Surf now. I can go to... Heck yeah, we're going there. I know what's at Cantaloupe City. So first we gotta teach Surf to Floatzel. A great way if you don't have a water Pokemon on your team, which you really don't need to, honestly. If you have like Gabite with strong ground type moves, you don't need a water type. You evolve Bidoof into a Bibarel, but Bibarel can learn Surf. Goodbye, Aqua Jet, you are useless. I believe we should be able to... That must have been it. It must have been the Surf. Is there water here stopping us from getting to Cantaloupe City? An X accuracy. I would like to Surf, thank you. Hey dude, what's up? Man of the Sea is also a man of Pokemon. Not necessarily, I mean. Guess I should be out here training Jolteon. Sailor never stood a chance. Magnemite. Actually, is Magnemite's ability levitate? I hope not. That even with times four, Magnemite still doesn't go down. Time Gabite learned a stronger sand move as well. Ground, sorry, not sand. That was it. Thought you'd get more experience than that. I'm gonna go back for those, because I can. Luke. Oh, that's a big change from a Remoraid. Thank you. guy was just fishing. We just showed up and murdered all of his fish. We're almost 39 on two of our Pokemon, because I think Staraptor's up there too. That's another Gyarados. Hopefully Gyarados doesn't know like Thunder Fang or something. That wouldn't be good. Really, Staraptor? Really? Isn't Fly a 100 accuracy move? Should get Jolteon up to 39? Question mark. Yeah. Jolteon's special attack is still only 83. That's pretty bad. Especially considering that's gonna be its last evolution. A hyper potion. Lead to a special place at all? I don't think I really noticed before that this is a little surfing place you can do. But it's the same thing. Hey. I guess so. Now display images of male and female. That's it. Okay. Yeah. Boy, I sure am thirsty. That was a reference to the first game where you had to give the guards. Tea. In red and blue. Subsequently in Fire Red and Leaf Green, which is the ones I played. At least I think that's the reference. I mean, that would make sense. Oh, that was going to be important. Alright, so we are in Canalave City. That's going to be the end of this episode. Next episode, we are going to find out why we came to Canalave City and see what there is and who there is. Catch you guys next time.